Hi, and welcome to the Unguendo Guitars Workshop. My name is Daniel, and in this video I'm going to show you all about how I route my pickup cavities. Of course, before we can start routing any pickup cavities, we're going to need a guitar body, and I've prepared these two guitar bodies in a previous video, and we're going to need a template of some sort. I like to make my own templates. It's not that difficult, but of course you can buy them online also, or at any store that sells guitar parts or accessories. They usually have pickup templates for humbuckers as well. I make my own. I always make a couple of copies just in case I damage one when using a router. And of course we're going to need a couple of router bits. I like to use 16 millimeter diameter bearing guided router bit with the bearing on the shaft side, and to make the nice and tight corners with small radius, I also like to use a quarter inch router bit with a quarter inch shaft, and of course a router of some sort and some measuring tools and a pencil. Now first let us take a look at where to place your pickups. So to properly place the pickups, and I'm going to use humbuckers for this guitar, I've attached the neck to figure out the position for the neck pickups pickup. And I like to use mounting rings. It makes placement much easier, and I can hide a small part of my neck joint. And I prefer the look of pickup rings personally over direct mounted pickups. And I think it makes for better adjustability to use pickup rings. So it's my personal preference. I like pickup rings, but not the cheap plastic ones. I always use real metal pickup rings. I don't like the plastic ones. First, the neck pickup is fairly easy. Just slide the pickup ring up against the neck. And I like to mark these two mounting holes. That's the center of the pickup. I've got my marks, and then I can use my protractor. Center the protractor, make sure it's nice and perpendicular to your center line. Find the two marks I just made and draw in a line. So that's the first pickup, is real easy to place. Second, the bridge pickup is a bit of a personal preference. The farther back you place it, the more trebly your sound gets from that pickup, so to say. I don't know the exact term, but I like, also again personal preference, to have about 10 millimeters between the front of the bridge and the inside of the pickup ring. It's just a personal preference. You can place it wherever you like. The further you go forward, that's the more warmer, in theory, your sound will get. I don't like to place it too near to the bridge, because that looks like a mistake, a very small edge. And I found that having a gap of 10 millimeters to the inside of the pickup ring, so it's about 7.5 between the bridge and the pickup ring, is aesthetically most pleasing. Mark these two positions, and I've already drawn in this line, but the process is the same. Just figure out how far you want your pickup to be from the bridge, and you can also measure it. It's about 30 millimeters from the front. Make a mark, make a perpendicular line, and now the two center lines of these pickups are in. And now I can use my template. And I've drawn in a center line, and the center line of the body and the center line of the pickup. And I can align
my templates with those marks. And this should be where my pickup goes.
So now with the positions of the humbuckers marked, I can stick on my template using masking tape and super glue, and then go over to the pillar drill to remove most of the material. And I'm going to route the cavities to a depth of about 20 millimeters, so just under an inch. And that fits most pickups easily. And I also have a bit of clearance underneath the pickup to run some wiring from the three-way switch through the pickup cavities to the main control cavities. And of course, for the bridge cavity, all the wiring has to go underneath the pickup. So it's a good idea to have a bit of extra clearance underneath your pickup for all the wiring. So yeah, let me get some masking tape and super glue and stick on this template. Because of the alignment and the precision you want in the alignment of your template, I like to mark the sides of my template. And stick some masking tape to these two sides of the template. And of course, put some masking tape on the guitar body. And now I can use that line to line up the masking tape. And in a moment, I use the same line to line up the template. Yep, perfect. And I always put my glue on the masking tape that's on the body and not on the masking tape that's on my template. Because if I misplace my template or the masking tape isn't in the exact correct position, I'd rather have my template stuck to a piece of masking tape than having my masking tape stuck and glued to my body. And I don't use any accelerator on my super glue and masking tape trick. And this gives me just a fraction of a second to make minor adjustments to my template placement. Like so. It's nice and stuck, so you really don't need any accelerator. On to the pillar drill. So to be fair, for the neck pickup with the neck pocket already here, it isn't really necessary to use the pillar drill to remove material because it's just two little sections right here. But I just like to do it has less strain on my router, and yeah, it prevents a bit of wear on my router bit. So to set the depth, and yeah, this is a very convenient pillar drill because of the digital gauge that shows me the depth. I can rest the point of my Forstner bit onto the material, zero out my
pillar drill and then lower it until it reaches 20 millimeters. And I can set my depth stop to 20 millimeters and it gives me the perfect result every time. And I know from experience this is fairly accurate. So yeah, very quick and easy job using the pillar drill to remove some of the waste for the neck pickup at least. And yeah, I think it's easier and less wear and such to use the pillar drill even for the smallest amount of waste removal than it is to use the router bit. Of course, you can by all means use the router. Speaking of the router, now I'm ready to start routing the first pickup cavity. And I'm going to use, like I said, a 16 millimeter diameter router bit, so fairly large bit. And it's only a short bit. It only has a cutting depth of 20 millimeters, so it's perfect for our pickup cavities. And of course it has a bearing, a guide bearing on the shaft side. And I can adjust the depth in such a way that the router is cutting all the material and the bearing is running along the template. So yeah, all set. I'm going to hook up some dust extraction, clamp the body to the bench, and I can start routing. So that's also another quick job using the big diameter router bit to remove most of the material. But the downside is because of the larger diameter router bit, the 16 millimeter diameter router bit, I now have a fairly large inside radius inside these corners. And yeah, they need to be a bit tighter. So I'm going to use another router bit, a 1/4 inch router bit with also a cutting depth of only 20 millimeters and a 1/4 inch shaft. So this router bit doesn't have a guide bearing, but because of the shaft has the same diameter as the cutting part of this router bit, I can use the shaft as it were a guide bearing. So I can very carefully adjust the cutting depth of this bit so that the polished part of the shaft is rubbing against my template. But when doing this, make sure the cutting part of your bit isn't up against your template because it will eat into your template. So I've got my 1/4 inch router bit installed and I made sure there's a nice portion about 10 millimeters of the shaft showing that I can use as a guide bearing along the template. And then just do the same again, route to the exact same depth and make sure you get nice and tight corners. So after the pass with the 1/4 inch bit, you can see I now have a nice and tight radius of only 1/8 inch, so just over 3 millimeters radius on the inside corners. And although it's going to be hidden by the pickup rings, I still think it's nice to have, and it's important to have nice and clean pickup cavities as well. So this one's done. Let's go to the bridge pickup.
And of course, for the bridge pickup, I'm going to do exactly the same. I now can remove this template. And stick it in the bridge position. And I like to double and triple check everything. And again, to the pillow drill. Again, very simple, using a Forstner bit, and I used two different ones to get into the small section at the end and remove most of the material. And I've switched once again to the bigger router bit, and I can start routing the cavity, and then again switch to the quarter inch to finish off the nice tight corners. So the first pass is done with the bigger router bit, and now you can see the bigger diameter on the inside corners that needs to be tightened up with the quarter inch bit. And here you can clearly see that the cutting surface is flush with the polished shaft, that you can run the shaft on your template to tighten up these corners. So one final thing to do to this pickup cavity, which I forgot to do on the neck pickup, so I have to revisit that one in a moment, that's to create an extra cavity or a bit of a recess in these two corners to fit the pickup mounting screw, and it allows for a slightly longer pickup mounting screw that helps with, for example, adjustability and makes pickup mounting a bit easier. So I'm going to take my quarter inch router bit, put it up against this corner, and just freehand route an extra cavity in these two corners. So these two small cavities are in now, and because it's very hard to see if you're routing in a straight line, I used a chisel just to clean up the edges somewhat. And that's how I route my pickup cavities. So here are our two pickup cavities all routed and done. And yeah, the final thing I like to do is take a piece of 320 grit sandpaper and just break the sharp edges, remove any fluff left by the router bit to give it a nice and clean and professional look. So now with these two pickup cavities fully done, I think you now know how to route your own cavities. I've got another guitar body to do for the guitar building series I'm working on, in which I'm building these two guitars at once. So if you haven't seen it, go check out my YouTube channel for the guitar building series. And if you like this video, please let me know by leaving a like, of course. And if you're new to my channel and you don't want to miss out on any of my future uploads, please consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell so you get notified when I upload something new. Yeah, next week's video will be, of course, the continuation of these two guitar builds. So I hope to see you all there. But until then, have a nice week.